So a hot topic right now is tariffs and how they're affecting businesses around the U.S. Like ours. And we just sort of wanted to share some insight on what we've seen, what we're doing, how it's affecting us, and also potentially more importantly, how it's affecting you. So Steph handles basically all of our pricing and everything like that at shop.EXPLORIST.life. And so she's going to be sort of running the show, and I'm just going to be throwing some questions at her, and we'll see if she knows the answers. So first question, how is it affecting our industry as a whole?
So it's affecting our industry as a whole quite a bit, mostly in the lithium batteries, because pretty much all lithium comes from China. That being said, the rest of the components and items in our electrical systems are pretty diverse, you know, come from pretty diverse locations. We source things from the U.S., we source things from Canada, we source things from Europe, we source things from, you know, India, Malaysia, all around the world. And so, you know, we're in a unique industry, I believe, because all of our items aren't sourced from one specific country, and that country being China specifically.
You know, can we take a, can we say that we're going to ever really put a blanket percentage increase on all of our stuff?
No.
Based on that?
No, absolutely not. You know, because we have such a diverse supply chain, and we have, you know, a bit of control over at least the things that we're sourcing, I don't think it would be fair at all to say that we're going to have a blanket increase. As of right now, we actually haven't increased our prices on any of our wiring kits. Now, we have increased prices on some things that have been mandated from other suppliers, like Victron's batteries, Victron's data cables, Epoch batteries. Most of the batteries have increased in prices.
Epoch was the biggest price change right off the bat. We got an email that was basically prices on those were going up. It was like 18 to 25% depending on the battery in question.
Yeah, and you guys asked a lot of questions about that because a lot of you unfortunately saw that in your carts, where we had built you a cart one day and the next day that cart was
$400, $800
more depending on how many batteries you had in that cart. So those are the biggest price changes so far. Like I said, we haven't actually increased prices on any of our wiring kits just yet. I'm not anticipating raising prices in the near future, or at least not significantly raising prices. So far, our kits, one of our wiring kits should have gone up. But it would have only gone up about $5, and so we opted to just not change that price.
And it also wasn't a very, like, popular kit. It was a sort of, like, it was a 48-volt system. I don't remember the specific detail of the exact wiring kit. But ultimately, yeah, it was, like, $5. It was not a very popular wiring kit, sort of a niche case. And so we're just like, you know, we'll just absorb that $5 for whoever ends up buying the wiring kit. That's not a big deal. So...
yeah. And so I think the main, I think another, you know, kind of talking point is just that we are trying to be very transparent about our pricing. And we do try to keep all of our pricing in line with the industry in terms of, especially with Amazon prices, with wiring and lugs and things like that. We are trying to always keep our prices within about 5% of what you can find on Amazon.
And that's 5% plus or minus. So we do quarterly checks to see if our prices are in line with Amazon. And if they fall, if they're more expensive than 5% of Amazon, we're going to drop our prices. If they are less than 5% of what we find on Amazon, so like discounted from Amazon, like too much basically, then we're going to raise those prices. So we always try to keep that line pretty close to what they've got going on over there.
Yep.
So let's talk more about Victron, because that was, I think, you know, that's the biggest supplier of components that we have on our site. And Victron came out with a list of their price increases. And like you said earlier, batteries and data cables were the biggest ones because those are made in China. And China currently has the highest percentage of tariff applied to it. Now, a lot of the solar charge controllers are made in India. A lot of the other components, I think the Victron Links distributor is made in Malaysia, I do believe. But ultimately, the Victron components are made in a whole bunch of different countries, and there are tariffs applied to India and Malaysia. I'm 95% sure right now, but that percentage is just way lower. And so I think the Victron just sort of isn't passing that on to us right now. Victron's been really good about, you know, sort of absorbing some of those prices. Like a couple years ago, I think it was like a year and a half ago, Victron dropped the prices on their solar charge controllers just because they were selling so many of them. They had a little bit better economy of scale. And so you guys saw a price decrease of solar charge controllers from Victron of like, it was like, what?
It was like
60%.
Yeah, it was significant.
It was a huge price drop. And so they're always going to do stuff like that to sort of help, you know, you guys. And so, you know, I think used to they were sort of the higher priced option. And if you sort of compared prices, they're not necessarily that much higher priced compared to what they used to be. Other big thing. So our wire, it's sourced, the wire is made in the USA.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, with tariffs and stuff like that, we don't know where our wire manufacturers are.
Sourcing the copper.
Yeah, sourcing the rubber insulating, you know, outside and stuff like that. So they're probably getting some tariffs applied on that stuff, depending on where they're sourcing their raw copper. But ultimately, we haven't seen prices on our end increase as a result of that to a huge degree.
Yeah, and not as a blanket increase either. We've seen some increases on individual items, on very specific things. But as a blanket statement, we haven't seen massive increases. But I, you know, that being said, this is changing pretty much daily. So this is as of today, May 6th, when we're shooting this. And what happens tomorrow, what happens next week, we don't know.
Yeah, so things could change drastically by the time that, you know, we've shot this, Grace edits it, and it's uploaded onto the site here in, you know, a week or three. And a lot of questions we've been getting is like, hey, like I have a project coming up this fall. What are prices going to be? And friends, if I knew what prices were going to be this fall, I'd be a very, very rich man because I'd have been betting on lots of horse races and stuff like that because that'd be, you know, seeing into the future. So realistically, like we have no idea. And if you want to lock in, if you want to have like a price guarantee of what components are going to cost by today, because the price you see today is the price you're going to pay today. And anything outside of that is who knows.
Yeah.
So I know that's not helpful, but
yeah,
that is.
Unfortunately, that's just the world we live in right now.
Yeah. So anything else about tariffs before we sort of wrap this up?
No.
Go through your notes. I think we covered everything. We didn't really go in order.
Yeah. You know, like we said before, we'll keep communicating any changes as we hear about them. And, you know, if that's via a YouTube video or a live stream or a newsletter or whatever, we're going to try to keep you guys in the loop as to what's going on.
Yeah.
As we know.
Actually, I do have another question before we wrap this up. Our batteries were the big component in question. Are there any battery manufacturers that we haven't gotten price increases yet?
Battleborne has not increased their prices. And I believe Rich Solar has not increased their prices just yet.
XPN 360. You know, they on the site yet? They might be on the site.
They're not on the site, and we did receive a price increase from them.
Okay. Yeah. So Rich Solar, Battleborne Batteries, we've not gotten price increases from them yet. So
as far as I know, those are the only two that I have not received a pricing.
And like I said, by the time this video goes live, that might have changed. By the time you're watching this video, unless you're watching it on the day one, you know, who knows? But like I said, this stuff is really fluid. So I think that's all. I think that checks all of our boxes. We hope this was at least helpful. If it wasn't helpful, we hope it was at least insightful into what we're seeing and how it's affecting you guys. But I think that's all for this week. We'll see you next time.